There are many thousands of genetic diseases. We know that all humans are carriers of some of these. This also counts for the gamete donors. However, many of the diseases are rare because a part, called recessive diseases, requires both parents to be carriers of the same disease in order for the child to inherit it. Some decisions and conditions are more complex because they are a combination of genetics, lifestyle, and environmental factors. Such conditions are called complex or multifactorial diseases. Although multifactorial conditions can cluster in families, they do not have a clear-cut pattern of inheritance. This also makes it challenging to determine an individual's risk of inheriting or passing on these conditions. Before a donor candidate can be accepted as a donor at Cryos, we look carefully into the family history of the donor. If there's anything in the donor's family history that points towards an enhanced risk that the donor carries serious genetic diseases, the donor candidate will be rejected. At Cryos, we follow all of the country standards and legislative demands by the EU, Danish, and US authorities to ensure compliance at all times with current genetic screening requirements. Even though the donors at Cryos are carefully screened and only roughly 10% of all donor applicants qualify as donors, we still receive report of conditions regarding the donor children. When we receive a report describing a condition in a child, we try to gain as much information about the case as possible to decide if the donor is released again. The decision is based on a careful assessment of the risk for having a child with that specific condition using the donor. If it's assessed that the donor is genetically associated with the condition, we send out a notice via email to all recipients who have purchased straws from the donor to tell that a condition has been ascribed to the donor and that more information can be found on the webpage. Here, you also have to keep in mind that you also have the right not to know. Please know that the gathered information will sometimes show that the condition is not related to the donor, in which case the donor will not be registered with a condition. To sum up, this means that a Cryos CON donor is a donor where a genetic condition has been ascribed after they entered the Cryos donor portfolio, and that the condition has been ascribed because a donor child is presenting a genetic condition. Such conditions varies in the degree of severity. Unfortunately, in many cases, it takes quite a lot of time before all investigations have been carried out and before a final risk assessment can be established with respect to the usage of the CON donor. We know that all humans are carriers of genetic diseases. We just lack the knowledge on which specific diseases it is. However, if you already have a child with a CON donor and you wish to have another child using this donor, we will advise you to seek local genetic counseling, which will help you to assess your specific situation. This also counts if you do not already have a child with a CON donor. In all matters, we need you to sign an informed consent to make sure that you understand that you are using a donor with a known genetic condition. Cryos is working hard to ensure that the information on the respective donor is as adequate and updated as possible and available at all times.